Welcome to Real-Time Signals Technologies. Today we will discuss data science terminology. Over time, working in data science, you will come to see and get comfortable with the industry jargon, maybe even calling a data science method or term of your own. In this video, I will introduce some of the major data science terms to get you started. So let's start with the big ones. Well, obviously data science. Well, I define data science as the unification or intersection or combination of domain knowledge, statistics, software programming, and machine learning. It's a multidisciplinary approach to data analysis. The second big one is data wrangling. This is my favorite, but try telling someone you are a data wrangler. Not a common profession outside of a certain technology circle. In traditional terms, it's just data preprocessing. But in data science, it's the first step to good data science. It's where you gather, filter, convert, explore, and assemble your data for analysis. Then we have machine learning. Can computers or computer programs come up with an algorithm from a statistical model based on input data? Does this model improve with more data? Can we measure its learning ability? That is, can we measure how well it performs? And also, how well it classifies or categorizes or groups or clusters data? And then we have big data. When traditional data storage, processing, and analysis techniques are no longer feasible because the data set has grown too large and too complex for current computing technology, when the conventional wisdom no longer applies, we say we are working in the realm of big data. And deep learning, this is a very common buzzword, if you will, we see in a lot of news articles from some big tech companies. It's just data science and machine learning industry jargon for neural networks. So, most new neural networks, their variants today are labeled as deep learning networks. They involve the multi-layered, very complex algorithms. And so, we will call them as deep learning. Now, there is some new terms and old terms. What we used to call statistician, we now call data science or data scientist. But within the realm of modern tech companies, you will also see machine learning versus statistical modeling. Well, machine learning is a little more than statistical modeling. I like to think of the newer terms as more multidisciplinary. They require pulling in knowledge from more than just a very narrow field of study. Big data versus data processing. Again, big data involves many more computer science ideas, more complex tasks dealing with distributed computing. Dealing with data storage across different areas, dealing with massive amounts of data, where the traditional data processing methods no longer apply. And obviously, deep learning versus neural networks. Most deep learning refers to neural networks, but it differentiates itself from the past ideas about neural networks by being more multi-layered, more complex. There is more depth in the modern neural network. It's evolved over time, and deep learning sets the modern approach to neural networks apart from the approach 25 or 30 years ago. Now, some other common terms that you should know that come up in data science discussion. We have data cleansing. That's just removing invalid, corrupt, or empty events from your dataset. Data integrity, it's about verifying the validity, consistency, and accuracy of your dataset. Data warehousing, it's probably what you would expect it to be. The storage of your data for retrieval and analysis. Where to store it? How to store it? What software storage? SQL? No SQL? File systems to use? Do we get into the realm of big data in our data warehousing? That's all that's referring to. It's pretty straightforward. I'd say these are fairly self-explanatory. Data anonymization, well, removing personally identifying information from a dataset. Predictive analytics, so this is about predicting future events or behavior, past based on analysis of past data. So it's decision making about the future using data science and machine learning techniques to predict. So it's used in marketing, insurance, finance, etc. There is much more jargon in data science than what I have presented here. But this should get you started on the big terms that get used regularly. You will need to take into account layman views of data science when communicating your results to non-data scientists. You should always know your audience when using data science jargon. When speaking with other data scientists, it's okay to stick to the jargon you know. It's a little more efficient communicating using the jargon than having to put everything into layman terms every time you explain something. And that concludes this introduction to some common data science terms. Thank you.